Zaatari refugee camp in Jordan, Syrian children are beginning to imagine a life beyond the conflict that has driven them from their homes. The classroom is a haven for these young ones caught in the largest refugee crisis the world has seen in 20 years. After visiting the children, UNICEF Director of Emergency Programs Ted Chaibin said 12,000 are registered for school in Zaatari, but there should be 40,000.
We're going into the new school year in September, where most children around the world are thinking, oh, I'm going back to school, I'm going to see my friends. And yet for the Syrian child, for many Syrian children, they're worried about security, they're worried about displacement, they're worried about what's going to happen to them.
The children told UNICEF Director of Communication Paloma Escudero that they were grateful to be safe in Jordan, but they yearn for the normalcy of their old lives.
They want to go back to normal life. They want to go back to being in a school, to play with their friends, to have a normal life for their parents. And I think that that's what we owe these children, to go back to a safe environment, to go back to school, to go back to a healthy and safe life.
Zaatari is now the second largest refugee camp in the world. It's home to more than half of the 600,000 refugees who flooded into Jordan. And it's just one part of the regional crisis that threatens to overwhelm the countries that border Syria. For Mr. Chaibin, who grew up in Lebanon during that country's civil war, the visit brought back memories.
It breaks my heart to see what's going on in Syria, to see children from different sects and different religious groups no longer be able to be with each other. But I have also come from a country which has come back from the brink of such a situation, which has rebuilt after such a conflict. And so there is hope for the Syrian child.
With no end to the conflict in sight and a funding shortfall, UNICEF and its partners have appealed to the global community to do more to give Syrian children the future they deserve. This is Chris Niles reporting. For more information, visit unicef.org.